rope.
One of the ship's sailors. Oh, he isn't a pretty sight. Almost unrecognizable. I was lucky. My God, I was lucky. The ship's disappeared completely. Not even any wreckage left. They can't all be dead. There must be other survivors of the shipwreck. They can't be very far. They'll answer me. I knew there were other swimmers as good as I in the crew. They must have come ashore further down. All I have to do is walk along the shore and I'll find them. The most important thing is to gather all the survivors together.
Oh!
What a nightmare. I'm afraid of the lizards now. And what if I encounter wild animals? I'm hungry. I'm hungry. A date palm. Just what I need. Oh, but I'll never have the strength to climb to the top. Well, I'm not going to take a chance killing myself by falling from a tree. That would be stupid. I'll try once I've rested. In Brazil, certain Indians nourish themselves by eating grasshoppers, which they call land shrimps. What country is this? Our ship left from Brazil and was making sail for Guyana. The gale took us by surprise in the middle of the Atlantic. It lasted 4 days. Where did the wind push us? At last, a fruit I know, a papaya. Since childhood, I've always carried a knife at my waist. Today, I bless that habit. Now I'm thirsty. Grass, flowers, trees. That means there must be fresh water around. But where is it hidden? The sun, the vegetation, everything seems to indicate the neighborhood of the tropics. But since the beginning of the storm, we weren't able to chart the ship's position. It's possible that I'm at some point on the coast of South America, maybe near the mouth of the Orinoco. I don't ask to come upon such a great river as that. The smallest brook would make me happy. I hope I'll find one in time. I've heard that it's much faster to die of thirst than of hunger. Anymore. I have to sleep. It would be best to curl up high in a tree to be safe from the wild animals. I'm going to try to perch on one of the huge horizontal branches of this baobab tree. It won't be a very secure shelter. If I can climb up there, the ferocious animals can do so too. A wild animal could get to the top of this tree in 3 jumps. And some snakes may get the idea of spending the night there, same as I. not. I think of all the dangers I risk, I'm going to go mad. And if I wake up face to face with a boa, we'll see which of us is more afraid of the other. And suppose I fall while sleeping. On the other hand, if I tie myself to the branch and I'm attacked by a wild animal, I'll be helpless. Too bad. I can't foresee everything. I'm lucky as it is to have escaped from the shipwreck. I don't even know the date of this day, which could have been my very last. Let's see. The gale lasted 4 days and 4 nights. It began September 12th. So today is September 16th, 1697. September, 1697. I left England, my country, 5 years ago. 5 years, during which my passion for traveling led me to my downfall. I was a very young man then, but the sea attracted me from childhood. As soon as I had a free moment, I went to stare at it for hours. I never got tired of the marvelous spectacle. My father had made a fortune in business, then had retired when my mother died. We lived in the city of York. He wanted me to continue my studies, like all fathers always have. Me? I only dreamed of adventures in far-off countries, but adventure already was awaiting me in my native country. What are you carrying there? Would you like me to help you?
No, we'll manage by ourselves. He might talk.
I thought they were splendid looking chaps, but they didn't seem to feel the same way about me. Why, in heaven's name? The explanation wasn't long in coming. They were smugglers. King's guards were on the spot. Oh, you can dream all you want of adventures. There are some times when you prefer to get home fast.
You!
Against my will, I found myself mixed up in the eternal war between the smugglers and the authorities. My father got me out of prison. I'd been very much afraid, but I feared even more the lecture which awaited me.
This is very serious, Robinson. A man's been killed.
No.
Did you know that?
The guard started shooting at us first. He was so young.
I pity his father. I am far more fortunate as I still have my son. All this will cost me is a little humiliation and money.
Money?
You've been sentenced to pay a heavy fine, otherwise it's prison. I prefer to pay. Unconditioned, it's the last time. You ought to realize that you're not a little boy anymore. You're responsible for your acts. I've already told you I believe it's high time that you selected a trade.
I thought you'd already picked one for me.
Because you seem incapable of it yourself. Have you any idea what you'd like to do?
I know I don't want to be a lawyer.
Why not?
Because it's a profession that disgusts me.
I'm afraid, judging by past experience, you have a tremendous disgust for work in general. Young men nowadays hardly ever feel like working, only making money.
I would like
to see the world. Yes, I know. And to see the world, you'd be willing to commit any folly. Like your friend Richard.
His father wanted him to be a tailor.
And he cut off the tip of his finger to make sure he could never hold a needle. Injuring yourself, how disgraceful. You'd be capable of it, too.
I don't want to be a tailor, Father.
If only you were able to choose a profession, anything, just as long as it's honorable. You don't care much for studies, granted. But I wouldn't blush to see my son a fine craftsman or honest merchant. I understand how you feel. I was young once, too, and knew that longing to get away. It seems to devour young men your age. Only, I resisted it. Look at me. If I had wasted my life racing around the world, what more would I have today?
Some memories, perhaps?
Insolence and sarcasm. They're also the earmarks of your age. And yet I tried to speak to you not like a father to a son, but more like a man to a man. Except you weren't listening to me.
What are your orders?
Well, if that's the way it is, I've no choice. I must force you to obedience. Tomorrow, you'll go to Woolsey's office. He'll give you your first law lesson. You're disgusted. He's expecting you.
You see, you did choose a profession for me after all.
Robinson, when I met your mother, we were both very young. Our life was very calm, and yet we were happy together. I lost her too soon. And I've never forgotten her.
Father...
As for memories, Robinson, I want you to know I've my share, too. Will you leave me now, please?
Before being chained to a professional career as a lawyer, I went to have a last breath of freedom by fencing with some comrades. It was my favorite sport, that which falsely quenched my thirst for adventure.
Well, lazy.
I arrived at Woosley's as delighted as a man being sent to prison for the rest of his life.
Why, it's Robinson, isn't he cute?
Where are you going in that disguise?
To a carnival?
To Woosley's.
To save you from hanging?
You're getting married.
Nonsense! Can't you see he's going to a funeral?
My father wants me to study law.
And what's the point of that?
To become a lawyer.
If we're ever arrested, we'll never consult anyone else but you.
We came to get you, to take you to another party.
Impossible. I've got to go to Woosley.
My dear man of law, rest assured we won't abandon you under such painful circumstances.
My friends, where are they now? And myself, where am I? I slept deeply. Where am I? I was lucky. Not one wild beast, not one snake came along. No matter what the circumstances, an Englishman must wash every morning. Our customs of decency and cleanliness distinguish us from other people. If there were any survivors of the shipwreck, they would answer me. If there were any inhabitants in this country, they would show themselves. How long will I have to go on walking to find other human beings?
Thank you.